They are everywhere. They drift through the traffic and the crowds, bottles of glue wedged firmly in their mouths. They knock on our car windows and make a gesture signaling they're hungry. But what do we really know about them? And does society even cast them a second glance to see how they can be helped? It is 4:30 a.m. in Nairobi, and we set out on a journey to catch up with Nairobi street children. It took us no time to find them. Here along Nairobi's Biashara Street, we see them huddled together, dead asleep. And as we capture their plight on camera, we bump into this disabled woman struggling to live. Our efforts to talk to her were futile, but seeing her walk away in this condition brought to life the challenges street families are forced to endure day in, day out. Around the corner we meet John Keriuki. He tells me he's in a hurry to sell recyclable materials to make a living, and he has to do so before daybreak. Any delay could see him run into trouble with the city county officers.
Akituona tukiokota hizi machupa za plastic na makarton na machupa za pombe kama Mickey's na Munuoka huwa wanatuchapa, halafu wanasema tunachafua jiji la Nairobi.
And as daylight breaks on this chilly morning, our journey to catch up with more street families in the city continues. Here in Isli we find these young boys. They spend the night on this cold, dirty hard pavement. Many of them have suffered from malnutrition, lack of sleep, and bear the pain from their continued exposure to the cold and rain.
Ignored, pitied and feared in equal measure, these kids find the street as the place to end their misery. But even the street, they are not safe. They are more vulnerable and they find it harsh. They are subjected to a whole range of violence, abuse and deprivation.
Many of them have tales to tell about the abuse they suffered in the hands of those they trusted the most.
Mamangu alisema atatudunga na kisu. Mimi nikatoroka nyumbani, nikaletwa huku na kijana mwingine. Na hapo kisha ndio siku hiyo nilijuanga bisi.
Despite the harsh times, many cling to the hope that there is a better future for them. This organization based in Eastleigh's 5th Street offers them basic education and food, but Moses Gisharu, a social worker here, tells me the kids still prefer heading back to the streets regularly.
They tend to have that urge to go back to drugs because they're in our boarding, they don't take drugs there. Another reason is because there we have rules and regulations whereby they should follow.
Despite the harsh surroundings, some of the street children keep nurturing their talent, hoping it will lift them out of poverty. There are those who have benefited from rehabilitation programs, including Samuel Kamau, who is now a proud father and boxing coach.
Niko na vita gum, niko na vita, niko na kunywa madawa, lakini ministry kakuja ikanisaidia, nikawa sasa nimebadilisha akili na nikawa mimi ndio mmoja wa wenye wamebadilika.
Samuel is one of the lucky few who have been able to find their footing in life. Deep inside this makeshift base in Isli, we find a 40-year-old man, Collins Camino, from Kakamega County, who is paralyzed on one side. He tells me he traveled to Nairobi in search of treatment, but financial constraint and lack of support forced him to seek refuge in the streets.
Usaidizi sina mtu wa kunisaidia. Nikienda kuna daiwa. Kuna daiwa mimi sina kitu yoyote nitaweza kupata kianga ndio nikue.
And as people like Collins battle with this condition, I just wonder how hard it will be for that mother to learn about her child in the street, in the cold and in the rain, how they try to survive with empty stomach, and how they are exposed to danger. And even though their search for better life remain elusive, these people have dream and aspiration. Given the chance, they can be important people in the society. Abdirahman Abdullahi for Citizen TV.